Hello, I am Serafín Martínez Jaramillo, an advisor to SEMLA's Director General Manuel Ramos Francia, and a member of the Editorial Advisory Board of the Latin American Journal of Central Banking. It is a privilege to participate in the digital luncheon of the Latin American Journal of Central Banking. During my presentation, I will be discussing on the relevance of research at central banks and how the journal will amplify its benefits in Latin America and the Caribbean. Research has become a very important undertaking in central banks. Nowadays, this activity goes beyond the traditional research areas. In effect, it is now very common to find that research is also being done at the financial stability, the central banking operations, and the financial markets and infrastructure units. This is a response to the critical need to back decision-making and policy design at central banks with solid fundamentals. For this purpose, research is crucial. Moreover, it has become a regular practice to find internships for PhD students in most central banks of the region. Nevertheless, the research process would be incomplete if the findings, the models, the discussions, and the policy implications are not shared or subject to further analysis, scrutiny, and debate with the regional and the international communities. Central banking, as well as supervisory and regulatory duties, are progressively becoming more sophisticated. This has taken place as the financial system has become a more complex system to study, supervise, and regulate. As a consequence, policy and decision-making has been transformed into highly specialized tasks. Research at central banks is also unique, as despite being considered to be applied, it is also rigorous. In addition, the fact that there is an actual application of our work makes us feel as researchers that we can improve the everyday lives of our fellow citizens. What is more, it is now more common to see scientific collaboration between central banks, researchers, and academics. This is a successful symbiosis that has produced already influential work in the fields of economics and finance. Additionally, central banks are custodians of unique data sets for which confidentiality must be preserved. Fortunately, this has not stopped central banks and researchers to use such data as long as the referred confidentiality is fully enforced. After many years of doing research at the Mexican Central Bank on financial stability, I have had the privilege of publishing a good number of papers, meeting world-class researchers and academics, also participating on inspiring scientific and policy conferences, and refereeing for international journals, joining international regulatory and research groups. My time at the bank has been really rewarding. Importantly, most of the research that I have done has been useful for decision making and policy design at Banco de México, as well as in some of the international standard setting bodies in which I have had the privilege of participating. Now, at SEMLA, I am leading a group with an extensive research agenda to be developed in close collaboration with several central banks in the region and academics worldwide. The topics in which our group is currently working include financial networks, climate change and its impact on the financial system, central bank digital currencies and blockchain technologies, financial technologies and their applications at central banks. An important question that comes to mind is why officials in central banks should publish scientific or policy papers. The answer has multiple components, among the most one relevance we can find. The journals are communication vehicles. Central banks do publish and communicate in many different ways, but scientific and policy papers represent a unique opportunity to develop in-depth important methodological aspects of their everyday duties. Also, to reach a wider audience, working papers and notes are one of the possibilities for publishing. But having an international reputed journal that reaches a highly specialized community will expand their reader space. Also, to open one work to a peer review process and allow for wider scrutiny of your models and methodology. For transparency reasons, the process of writing a rigorous scientific paper should leave less space for ambiguity and opacity. And finally, to contribute to the economics and finance fields with original and relevant research. Having a promising journal will bring enormous benefits to the researchers in the SEMLA's membership. Relatedly, this journal will have an international reputation on central bank research with a long-term perspective and the advice of international renowned academics and policymakers. The journal will be also an ideal forum for knowledge interchange among academics and policymakers as well as an inspiration for young researchers in the region. Before concluding, I would like to stress that the unique opportunity that research has brought to my career is a key factor of the satisfaction that I have to work at a central bank. Research is a challenging path to choose, but it is also tremendously enriching and rewarding. For all these reasons, I have the conviction that the Latin American Journal of Central Banking will bring enormous satisfaction to SEMLA's members and also to the numerous academics in the region. I am certain that we are witnessing the launch of a successful and high-impact journal. Thank you very much for your attention.